Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's me, Brigitta. I have a short project share for you. And after that, I am going to give you a quick tour of my craft room because I cleaned it and redecorated it a little bit yesterday. So the small projects I'm going to show you are two beautiful, I think they're beautiful, Christmas boxes that I made. And I was so inspired by that, by Nicole from Nicole's Silhouette Design here on YouTube. She made a digital cut file from a hard box, and KS Craft made it into a die. And I loved it so much that I bought it, and I wanted to make two boxes from it for Christmas to give my mother and my mother-in-law their gifts in. And this is the first one I did. So yeah, look how beautiful this box is. When I have it near my hand, you can see the size a little bit. It's perfect, not too big, not too small. I love it. And it has two drawers that comes out. Have to be careful because I already put the gift in. Here I can see, you can see it better. So two drawers come out of the box and you can stuff things in it. To open it, you can do several things. In the video from Nicole, where she showed you how to assemble this, and I will put it in the description box below, as well as a link to the KS Craft store, because yeah, I think you need, well, I needed the explanation from Nicole to assemble this box. When you have done it, it's really simple. The second time you do it, poof, in the half of the time that you did the first one. But for the first time, I think you need a tutorial. Nicole had some brads or knobs on the drawers to put them out. I will show it to you. I just attached loops of ribbon so you can pull them out. Really simple, but really effective. On this one, I used some beautiful plaid paper. All the paper that I used on these boxes come from our local store. And I have this die in my stash for quite a while, and I still love it because it's quite dimensional and I really love the layering that it gives. And I really like to attach these or to put these bows together with a brad, because when you cut the bows out, they come with holes in it and you can really easy put them together with the brad. And because this brad matches the box so well, I just left it like this. So yeah, this is the first one. This is the other one I did, so that's exactly the same, but just with different Christmas paper. Different bow, different color bow, of course, but it's the same. So yeah. As well, come out. So yeah, this was my quick little project share. If you stay here in this video, then you will see a quick walk through my craft room. Maybe you like that. And yeah, I hope you will be back for my next video. Thank you for watching. Bye bye. So I will show you my craft room. I don't think I have shared it before, but last night last Sunday, yesterday, my husband put up some extra shelves for me so I could redecorate, and I have cleaned my craft room really, really thorough. That was a long time. I even came behind every cupboard, etc. So this is the best time to show you my craft room, I think. I'm not going to show you everything in my bins, but just a quick view how my craft room looks. So yeah, and I have the smallest room in the house, of course, because my kids and my husband and me have the other rooms, but it's large enough for me. And when you enter my room, you see this iron cupboard. That's an old one that I have for quite a long time. It came from my husband's old work, and it is filled with things to craft with. And as you can see, also with different things, because that are chocolate letters for this Saturday. Then we have a Dutch holiday that's called Sinterklaas. And we don't celebrate it anymore because my kids are too old for that. But they do still get their chocolate letters. So yeah, I zoom out a little bit. Here's my craft desk. The desk is made at my work. I work at an interior building company, so yeah, the desk was made there. And a lot of Christmas paper and other paper on it, of course. I have some IKEA rails above my desk. I have them for several years. My computer is here. Here are two of the shelves that we put on extra so I could display some things on that I have made and that I received, but also some stash. And I really like this heart. I already had it, but I let my husband spray it gold yesterday. And I added all my things that I got in beautiful shabby colors, so I love it. So yeah, that's the other one. Here is a reel with cards that I did, that I made myself, so that I don't forget I have them and I can send them out. And here are a different shelf, some cards I received. They are both from Sheila, I think, yeah. And here, a big three-tier tray with all my flowers and other things. The umbrella on top is made by Sandy, Decorate Your Life, in a swap we did a few years ago. Some wands in it that I received. A beautiful wood letter I received once from Shonda in a rack. So yeah, so here's the other big shelf with all stuff on it. It's really hard to film because it's small here. Here's my other cupboard with some embellishments. I have this lovely smell from Rituals. It was an early gift from my boss for me for Christmas. We also get a Christmas package, quite a large one every year, but he gifted this to me already. So my room smells amazing. And here behind my door, there you can see a little bit of my daughter's room in the bathroom, is my sewing machine. And in the pink boxes, there are a lot of layouts that I did in the past. I did a lot of scrapbooking layouts, but mostly mixed media ones, so they don't go into albums, they don't fit. So yeah, and here behind is my old die cutting machine, my cuddle bug, and some wrapping paper. And that old cupboard there holds embellishments sorted by color. And yeah, my printer is here, an old cupboard that's filled with our administration from home. So yeah, that needs to be somewhere as well. So yeah, now you have an idea how I sit to craft. It's really my safe haven. I love this room. And yeah, I spend a lot of hours in it when I am off and have time to craft. So yeah. Oh, and that big box there, that houses all my dies. And they rarely fit in. So yeah. Yeah, if you like my video, please give me a thumbs up. If you want to see more of my room in more detail, you can write that in the description box below, and maybe I will do a video about that. But I must say, because I have a small room, all the blue bins houses different things, so they are not all filled with just one kind of thing. So yeah. Okay, thank you for watching. Bye bye.